What's good, internet? My name is Attax. Like, welcome to Keys from My Inbox, the show where I look at games that show up in my email inbox because I have a lot of subscribers or something. This is Darknet for the PC, for Steam, also on the PS4, and primarily meant for virtual reality. As always, full disclosure, this copy of the game provided by the publisher. Now, you might wonder, why am I sitting here playing this game, Darknet, with a mouse and not playing it with a VR headset? Well, that is quite simple. For whatever reason, they sent me a PC code, and as those of you who are fans of the channel might know, I've only got the PlayStation VR headset back there somewhere, and they didn't send the PSVR version of this game, so therefore I'm looking at the PC version on a desktop, because you can play it on a desktop. But you can kind of imagine how the VR of this game would work. Now, this is a puzzle game about hacking. And so if you are not interested in puzzle games or hacking games, this kind of might not interest you. But I think it's kind of neat. We're going to hop in here and resume this hack and show you just what I mean here in Darknet. Now then, there is kind of a lot going on here, but not really. It can be a little bit visually overwhelming. You can see here I have a timer. I have not started hacking yet, so the timer is not clicking down just yet. And my goal is to get to the root of this server. And the root would be, let's go find it here. There's the root. The big old one that glows with the thing, green thing in the middle. And how we do that is by hacking these different nodes and earning money, and then therefore getting more money and hacking more nodes, etc., etc. So we'll take out a node in this area here with a value of 1.5k. So this game, as a puzzle game, I start with one virus here. The timer begins to click down, and when it hits zero, I fail, right? And all these blue pieces right here can be used to inject your virus. But as it spreads, if a blue piece touches another blue piece here, the blue spreads twice as fast as the purple does, right? So ideally, you want to have more than one. You want to go into the shop here and buy another one. Buy one, right? And then now I will have two. So we'll head back in here with two. And when there are two, then I can kind of say, all right, well, let's do right here, right? And it will hit that and trigger these, you know, in a direction. But then those have already been triggered, and I can kind of get my way, hopefully, through here. But I already screwed it up, so we'll try it again. Let's go over here and try one and see if we can't trigger that. And then it's still going to be too close, right? So sometimes you want to use multiple. So say if I use this one and this one, then maybe I can get there in time without it getting... Yeah, no. All right, I'm already botching this pretty hard. Let's go over here. This seems better, yes. Hit that one, right? That'll hit that one, right? Then we're clear. So this one on the corner here, we hit, and then it will arch its way over as it goes through this mainframe, and it will definitely get purple there to the middle before the blue is able to catch it, right? So now that we've done that, and our total funds at the moment are 40.1k. Now what we really want here is a Hydra, because the Hydra allows you to spread that hack to any other of these nodes that don't have a shield on them, right? So all these can be collected, so we're just going to hit here and go Hydra, right? And then watch our handiwork spread and our money rise. And the money rising is definitely a good thing. So now we have $35,000 to play with. And we have worms, and worms will corrupt the node. And we have exploits that will take down firewalls, because firewalls are important to take down. But first and foremost, we're going to buy another one of these deals here. So now I got three of those, right? So again, our goal here is root, and it has four firewalls, but the root is surrounded by all these freaking sentinels that have their own firewalls. So you have to judge what is the best course of entry, what is the best way to get around these things and head into one that is shielded in some way. So we have three here, right? So what's gonna be our best course is to go bop bop bop, and then hope that is enough to take out this. Yeah, it will be. Not a problem. Not a problem. Got that money. Got that green. And yes, I know worms. So I have 32.2. So let's see how that's gonna go. I haven't actually bought a worm yet, so I'm curious. Do I do it here? Yes. And then how does that actually spread? Alright, sure. Cool. Alright. That works for me. But look at that shit, right? Look at that. If any of those get hit by what I have over here, so if I always do this, right, and then get these to trigger, and then do that, and then kind of get this over here, it's not going to matter, right? It's legit not going to matter, because if I go over here and hit this guy, and it gets all the way there, the fact that they're so shielded, it's just going to cancel out the whole bit of business. So it's not worth doing just yet, as it were. But it is corrupted, so that's going to help us out in the near future. We're kind of going in the wrong direction here, but that's kind of neither here nor there. But let's kind of just hit up this stuff here, do some of that, and trigger those guys to do that, and then trigger this guy to do this. And then ideally, this should make it around in time to... Yeah, it got there. It got there. As long as one bit of purple gets to the node in the center, then you are good. You are good. And that helps to weaken this bit of business here. And we're going to hit up this big old sentinel here and see if we can't take over this big boy. So obviously, the bigger the circle, the bigger the puzzle that is inside the circle. So if I do you and you and just go bam, then that actually might just get there without... Yeah, it'll get there. Okay. Yep. That has been captured. So this whole game is played on a mouse. It is your left click and right click. And that's kind of all there is to it in terms of your controls. And I found it to be pretty enjoyable thus far. But it kind of depends on how much of a brain teaser you want to deal with in your life, I suppose. So when we take out that shielding, that should help us take out... Yeah, see? The shield here is now donezo. So how, pray tell, should we take out this bit of business? So if we hit these to hit these, and then we got two. All right, so if I hit this guy here, then ideally this guy should make it all the way to there. That should be enough space, in theory. Because it moves fast, but not as fast as you might think it moves, right? So, as long as you can get there in time, look at all that moolah. Look at all that green stacking them pages and papers and bits and bytes and, you know, all that good stuff, right? So, that is now captured. We got that boy, right? So, now we got a whole lot of money and can buy many more of these. I got six now. I've got six now, right? So now we gotta start moving around in a different direction because we need to get, you know, in here, and we have 14 minutes left to do it in, right? So let's see if I inject another of the hydras and put that over here. I'm sorry, that was the wrong button. That was the wrong button. No, back out, back out, back out.
Error.
Oh no.
You cannot enter a node you have already captured.
Yeah. Buy a Hydra, and then put in a Hydra here to get these guys taken out. Just, you know, to make things faster. Because we're not going to go around this way. So, let's see if we can kind of speed these things up a little bit. And we have six now, so six is quite a bit. So if we kind of just go boop, 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 like that. We have done enough surrounding here that it's not going to matter when it hits things over here, because I just get there in time, and it's not a problem. So we're going to keep on hitting our node business as we work our way around this thing. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's, you know, easy peasy. Easy breezy. Beautiful. Cover girl. And then heading around. So now we've made it over to here. And these are shielded, but they're little tiny guys, so it's not that big of a deal. That should be enough, actually. Just two should be enough. I'll just get there, and it won't even be a problem. And it won't even be a problem. Just minimal damage minimal risk. But sentinels here are a problem, so we gotta get our exploits, buy that, and do that to help out with that stuff, and that helps us a lot. And then we head into this sentinel here and see how that looks. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All that cash. Who gonna stop me? Who gonna stop me, huh? I'm gonna get this network. I'm gonna get this work. I'm gonna take them bitcoins. What you gonna do? Nothing. And I like it. So that gives us access to the root. It has 2 firewalls. So let's try to buy some more stuff here and see if we can't weaken them firewalls a little bit. Yeah, 1 more firewall. Get one more. I've got plenty of money.
Error.
Oh.
If you wish to
really?
Enter a node, select viruses from the menu.
Whatever. Whatever. There we go. Root is now available. We are heading into a root, getting ourselves some root access to this machine. And it is so big. It is so big. I can only imagine that this looks amazing in VR. But clearly, I don't have that PC headset working in my favor, unfortunately. So let's just kind of hit these 3 and see if that gives us perfect. And then hit that one and see if that's going to make it. It might not, but it might. It's going to be cutting it really, really, really. Nope. So up here was the problem, right? So you hit right click and you reset. So if that's going to be a problem, then we can take that out like that. And this guy, like that. I still have, what, 4 left? Like that. We'll do these 2. And that should take those out. And then this one, I got 1 left. So we're gonna, fingers crossed, this is gonna go all the way. See, one down there, it might be a problem. That one, that might be a, no, no, get there! That was not quite enough. All right, well, let's get back out here. We still have time to back out here and, let's see here. Can I afford to buy? Yep. Now I have 8. Now I have 8. You would think 8 should be overkill for what this currently is. But I think that right here is my best bet on this bid business. So, let's kind of say 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here, and do that. Get those to pop off, and then do some there to make those pop off, and then there to make that pop off, and then maybe I got left. No, not that one. And then maybe that's enough. Maybe that will get me all the way to, yeah, that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. Going for it, going for it, going for it. And we have our root access here in Darknet. We have done it. We have obliterated this network. Give me them 25 bitcoins and download that data. Give me that data. Do it. Doing it and doing it and doing it well. Oh, God. Hack the planet. Hack the Gibson, etc., etc. So there you go. That is Darknet on Steam, on PS4. It's $15. It is a pretty neat experience. I would say obviously a lot more neat if you have a VR headset that is compatible with the game, which I currently don't on the PC, unfortunately. That's kind of where I'm at in my life. But yeah, go check it out. I think it's pretty cool. If you want a hacking puzzle game, I think it is pretty neat. Anyway, I'm a Tax Slug. Thanks for watching. More videos every day. And I'll see you next time right here on this channel. And I'm out.